in the air, but I don't know what that was. It's in the water. Kristin Frizzle from the National Aquarium is here to tell us about a post-Valentine's Day date after hours at the aquarium. And Kristin Frizzle is here with her as well.
Yeah.
She just scared me.
Well, she has a very loud voice, as you can hear, which she definitely uses that voice to her advantage because she loves attention.
Okay.
So since it is February, the National Aquarium is celebrating love, and we are offering discounts for couples, as well as Valentine's Day is on Friday this year, so we do have our Fridays After 5 going on. And then we... She's going to tell you all about it, apparently. She's saying... All right, let's go ahead and see if we can give her a nice piece of wood here to chew up for you guys, because she does have a very big, strong beak, so she uses that beak to crack into lots of wood pieces and...
I don't know if I should feed her...
a hazelnut?
Yeah.
Hey, you guys bonded, you know, it's a month of love. You guys are doing great.
Like, I thought she was going to take my head off or something.
No, no. So she's a hyacinth macaw. They're the largest parrot species found in Brazil, and they do specialize in eating Brazil nuts, so that's why she's cracking that wood. She's cracking that outer nut shell. They're about the same bite as an alligator or crocodile, so very, very strong and very messy. As you can see, there's hazelnut pieces going everywhere. So... they drop about half of what they eat.
Why is she looking at me like that?
She's flirting with you. She's bouncing up and down. She's getting excited.
Okay, I fed you. I let you eat from my hand.
She remembers. She just loved it so much that she wanted some more.
Okay.
So she is a monogamous species, which, of course, going back to Valentine's Day in the month of February, monogamous meaning that she picks one mate that she's going to spend her entire life with. She loves attention. That's why she's doing that loud call. She loves everybody to look at her, all eyes to be on her. And if they're not on her, she does that loud, what we call a contact call, in order to get their attention and bring
Who's
them over
mate?
To check her out. Well, Margaret is a very social bird, so we hang out with her. We spend a lot of time with her. She
so
loves people. Well, not just me. We do have a lot of people that work with her, because what's very specific about parrots is that if they do pick a mate, they get very aggressive and nasty to everybody else. So we all have to be very careful with how much time we spend with her so that she doesn't just bond to one person.
That explains a lot, everybody.
Now, in addition to Margaret here, we'll
let
go ahead and...
Have I got a feed?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Here, let's go ahead and get you the hazelnut. Excellent job. See, I told you guys had a good bonding experience.
Alrighty.
Alright, so over here we have Rufus, and Rufus is a shingleback skink, so I'll go ahead and trade and let you get a closer look
over here.
At Rufus. So shingleback skinks get their name because their scales look like shingles on a roof, which is how Rufus gets his name, and his scales are nice and smooth. He kind of looks like a pine cone, so they're also known as a pine cone lizard, and they're also known as a two-headed lizard, so take a look at his face. And compare it to his tail.
I was going to say.
Yeah, it's a very short, stubby, wide tail, and that's normal.
This looks like a face.
Exactly. They like to sit in a U shape, so that way other animals aren't quite sure which one is their head and which one is their tail.
That's kind of, okay, they're giving me the cut off. So
yeah, so come on down.
Lovely friends, and you can meet them at date night on the National Aquarium on the 15th.
Yeah.
All right, at 7 to 10. Thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you for having us.
Bye-bye. Remember, I fed you.